out of the mouths of babes and infants, you have established strength because of your foes to still the enemy and the avenger. Psalm 8:2. 3 weeks ago, I took a road trip to San Diego after receiving news that my special needs uncle, Uncle Lili, was on life support. He choked on a sandwich, and I guess there was like 10 minutes that passed before he was even able to get help. So the doctors were saying that he had severe swelling in his brain. I mean, and mind you, granted, he already had brain damage as it is. It was kind of slow a little bit. So this was not a good thing. And even though he had a pulse, he wasn't responding. And so the family decided and agreed that we would keep him on life support to protect and preserve the organs so that it could be a benefit to some other people. He ended up saving 3 lives, which was awesome. It's interesting how losing someone really helps you to understand the value of life and time. So it was really great to be with my family at that time. To me, my Uncle Lili was just a happy smile. And he had like the most simple comments and logic, and he just was a very innocent. He had an innocent perspective on the world. He lit up every occasion. Everybody loved Uncle Lili. It's crazy how when you lose brain power and you're not all there, it actually eliminates a lot of the mental clutter that causes so much stress. And most of us, it's hard to have clarity and make simple decisions when we're so stressed out. So in a sense, he was kind of blessed. During my 2-week stay there, I was able to spend a lot of time with family members I haven't seen in a long time, uncles and aunts, and all my siblings, my sister, my brothers, my mom, and nieces, nephews. It's been pretty awesome being able to have this reunion. It's been difficult trying to plan a funeral around this pandemic where they're limiting social gatherings, and there's just so many of us that we really have to kind of wait a little while in order to accommodate everyone. So we just enjoyed the reunion that Uncle Lili inspired. We took advantage of it, and it was just bittersweet. It was beautiful. So my little sister Jamie gave me 3 beautiful nieces, and I've never had a daughter. So of course, I like to spoil my baby nieces. They're all under the age of 10. And Ashlyn Ella, a little darling blonde towhead cutesy with like the prettiest little smile. She's 4. Ashlyn is faux. That's how she says it. So I had the opportunity of spending time with her and interviewing her. So you're gonna really enjoy this one. All right. Hi, Ashlyn.
Hi.
I was wondering if you would mind answering a couple of questions for me so I can tell everybody about it. I need help.
Okay,
so Ashlyn, if you were the president of the United States of America, what would you do to help your people right now?
I would get the medicine.
What if you didn't know where the medicine was?
I would clean up so that they can see it.
What a great idea. When things are messy, it's really hard to find anything, that's for sure. What else would you do for them? How would you protect them?
Go get a type of ting that would help them wake up so they can't die from the coronavirus.
Do you think that it works to wear masks?
Yes.
Well, how do you know that?
'Cause I listened to my teacher. I learned about masks.
That's very smart. What do you do to cure boredom at home, where you're home all the time with your sisters?
I don't know about that, but I guess I don't. Oh, hold on.
Okay.
Sally, there's someone talking.
Oh, okay. I'm glad you're back. What can kids do to not be bored, Ashy?
See, so I don't know. I don't have an idea. Just tell them to do a game. I pie with my little eye something that is yellow. Do you know that game? You start.
Well, how the heck am I supposed to see what you're spying from all the way over here in Las Vegas?
Come over.
Well, I will be back there in a couple of weeks for sure.
Yeah.
What kind of jokes do you tell your sisters?
Those inside jokes to stay home.
That's very smart. Thank you so much, President Ashlyn, for all of your advice. We really needed your help.
You're welcome.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye.
So President Ashlyn gave us a really good set of tips there that can really help all of us. So number one, do you remember? Give them medicine. Number two, clean up so they can find the medicine, which is really genius if you think about it. How much mental clutter and all kinds of clutter. Imagine what the president has to go through. If he's good or bad, doesn't matter. Anybody up there is going to have to deal with some clutter. Number three, wake them up so that they don't die from the coronavirus. Get them some sort of thing to wake them up. Number four, play I Spy with my little eye, which kind of makes sense if you think about it, because it's kind of like a focus game. So it allows them to kind of be distracted from reality for a little bit. And then tell inside jokes. That's so funny. Kids say the darndest things. So in closing here, after this funny story, I'm going to give you a beautiful quote. It goes like this. All children are artists, but the problem is how they remain artists when they grow up. Picasso. Thank you, guys.